thing, but it would be good to at least hear briefly
from Swami.
Hello everyone.
So
it's my day session here. It's really nice to see faces in the computer screen after a long time. And it's really nice to sit through all the MSc presentations. It reminded me how it was 20 years ago exactly when Dr. Kumar was our host at XVII M.Sc. And just recollecting various things that Stroman was my immediate senior. And we overlap quite a bit with batch with us. So I think each batch that comes out of WI has its own unique characters. And it's quite amazing what putting a group of strangers together in a hostel for 2 years can do. The kind of trajectories that takes in terms of learning, in terms of interactions, in terms of where things are living and careers. So it's campus itself, I think, is a fantastic learning space. The interactions we have with the wildlife on campus and other creatures, including human beings. I mean, it's always so much to learn every day. Theses that were presented for me were really exciting because for a change, for the first time, I saw some WI batch theses that were being done with the relevance to local ecology. That's really quite an outlier. I don't recall so many theses which cover Dehradun, Rajajiri, or Masuri, or the immediate landscape. Okay, the reason I say that this is exciting for me is because I always had a strong belief or approach that we need to address local questions, local ecologies, wherever we are, whichever institution we are. And there are several problems that we can solve if we collectively work towards addressing issues locally, which is not possible if we were to think about all of the country all the time. Of course, it's really important to go out and study places beyond as well, but I think it's very, very important to have a good focus on local issues as well. It's very exciting to see a lot of great natural history, a lot of great ecology. One study on the jury, see this person, it's always nice. And it's always nice to see students who kind of said, I will keep it simple, I won't go and do very complex concepts. I will kind of keep it simple. I do what I understand, and I'll get it at that. Nice to hear about all the learning journeys you've been on, and I wish you all the very best.
So, thank you for inviting me. It was a real pleasure coming back and meeting with my teachers. And after 20 years, I mean, so it's been a while, probably. Yeah. But a couple of things I wanted to say. First of all, the quality was really good because I couldn't sense that this was a COVID year. I mean, you know, I've been surfing the net for the different projects people have been doing over the years in WI. I mean, if you wouldn't tell me that this was a COVID year last year and just given me a license to kind of evaluate, I would say the quality was equally good. So this is huge credit to you all as well as the advisors, because I think the work is very good. So that's one thing, so congratulations. So the second thing is, don't take these projects as your ultimate thing which you want to continue to do in your entire life. Open up your mind, these are just tools, techniques, different kind of opportunities will come. So don't close up that this is the only thing which you want to do. Yeah, so that's one kind of bit of advice I would say. Because if you follow up all the different batches, different people in different institutions, they've been doing very different things. Right. And the last thing I think you all don't realize what a unique course this is even globally. So I've traveled to many countries, worked in many countries, seen this is the only place you will be able to work with practitioners, you know, and scientists together. No other institution will be able to do that. There are many institutions which give you master's degree, right, and even PhD degrees, but this is the only kind in the world, let me know, tell you, where you'll be able to learn a lot of the practical side. And that's very important, especially in conservation and even ecology, right? So take that as a, you know, something very, you know, to be privileged about and lucky to be able to. Thank you.
I must say that I'm going back a much wiser man than when I came here 3 days ago. You committed yourself to all the recitations, amazing diversity of taxa, geographical diversity, topic diversity, it's an amazing experience. If I had learned this otherwise, I'd spend a year in a library. So, it's just done 3 days back. So, I thought it was fitting to 9 dissertations and then doing 9, I would say which one would be really tough, but I really, really enjoyed it. And because I would learn a lot. That is one thing, and since both Soumya and Soumen talked about 20 years, I should talk about 30 years. And I was a faculty here before any of you were born, any of the students were born. And how things have changed over time. So when I was here, this in 1987, only statistics, there was no statistics. Only things that were done was pie charts. Many of you may not even know what pie charts is. You are just using pie charts. Everything was pie charts. There were 100% pie charts. Just one thing, just 100 only one color. And there was no concept of sample size, etc. And at that time, I had come from finishing my PhD and I knew how to do chi squares. And then I knew how to do t-tests from the people who changed and from 5 years ago inside another this stats doctor in campus. Everybody was come running and I'll do chi square testing. You know, and it was at that time SPS system. I only dropped my own SPS system. And then things changed and moved on from T-Test to things like PCA and everybody was doing PCA and everybody was saying Axis 1, Axis 2. Nobody knew what is the Axis mean. Axis 1 is everything is displayed as Axis 1, Axis 2. From there we have moved on to, now I suppose, model selection. So that is the thing is many people doing model selection. So things have changed. Things have changed in terms of maps. So when I joined here, we had AutoCAD. You may not know what is AutoCAD. So we could draw, so the way we used to estimate area of a PA was that we would draw, digitize it, print it out, cut the paper, weight, and then we have a weight of 1 square centimeter paper. And then this is like 10 grams and that is how we estimate the capital. So you know you guys are not doing anything any of those. And that's presentation. So that's where my problem is, because presentation, we had to really struggle, I mean not me, you guys. Had to struggle through presentation because it's all done on all species. And you have to write. And you can we have to think 3 times. Before we what we wrote on that thing. And because you can't write that, large text. And OSP sheets cost money. And they're always in short supply. And very difficult to erase once you have written. So people thought a lot before they wrote something in that thing. That is something I don't see here. When you not simply, you know, lot of text on the PPT slides, everything is put left to the audience. What you need to really tell the audience. Very complicated graphs put up, and you have like 30 seconds to understand more and more of the next slide. And you don't explain what is the x-axis, what is the y-axis, what is that big color thing. So that is one problem I have, and it's not a problem, it's a common problem that you have. with large number of slides for continuing presentation, you cannot have your phone, you have a better phone. Then you could understand 2 or 3 minutes of each slide and understand this slide. Okay, it's not necessary. I know you did amazing work, you did proper analysis, etc. I know you tell the audience everything about what you did. But the audience doesn't have the capacity to absorb. So you can use the things you can what is really reading. And the other thing, final thing is that you can tell it. So there are two ways of people do. So if you are given a piece of paper and said that's all you have, one A4 piece of paper, and you can write what, you know, some people will do, and that's what you want to tell in here. Others will produce a font. So it's the same with presentation, you have only 50 minutes to say. You can either talk in your normal speech, many of you will talk fast. Well, just talking fast is not an answer to telling something in 15 minutes. You talk slowly and you need to. So those are things that I really wanted to tell. And these are part of the problem. They are asking me about the problem, but I was telling. The stacks have changed, the technologies have changed. You can't even use it. Waiting up technology from doing. Now, there is camera flag, there is REM, there is CPDS, all kinds of stuff. But have you really changed the question that you're asking? Or still you're continuing to ask the same questions? But using better than numbers. You're still talking about algebra, you're still talking about numbers, you're still talking about. You're not asking a bigger question. It's because of technology. There's delegates, there are commons, what kind of question that you can ask to understand biology of it. It's a common problem as a community, we need to think about. We're stuck on numbers. We're stuck on algebra. We're stuck on these two things. I think there are some other interesting presentations we're stuck on. But otherwise, as a community, why is it that we're stuck on numbers? We're stuck on algebra. Going horizontally.
You're not doing something, you're not doing something.
You are done only 10 years ago, so now doing again technically. Like that. You don't need to think deeply about how do you build this model from words. Not so. So the technology. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Ajit, for taking us down the memory lane. And anyway, I'll be with you. Yeah. Anyway, I'll be very brief. We are already for the lunch hour, but let me first congratulate all of you. You did exceptionally well. I was here largely throughout your presentations, and I really enjoyed it. And as he rightly said, it was so much of knowledge coming in over a brief period of time. And so varied, yet, I mean, they were all very well thought, well researched. Congratulations to you. And also, of course, to the supervisors. And, well, I don't have to repeat that this has been a difficult year, but you all won over it and still produced such a marvelous work. So, hats off to all of you. I mean, I'm not saying it by looking at things from a distance. I was personally involved in 3 of the dissertations, and I could see that how difficult it was to work in the field in this year particularly, and some of you even faced some very serious personal problems, but you managed to win over it and still produce such marvelous work. So it's really wonderful. And I'll just add on to what Dr. Ajit said. I think most important thing is that you should always have a questioning mind. You should keep questioning things. I mean, that's how a researcher should be. You should not go static. And that's perhaps one way of going vertically and not horizontally. And another thing, I think we people in the conservation sector often are just interacting with each other. We need to interact with the outside world. And that's where I think what Shoman very rightly said, ours is a very special course. This actually gives you exposure to the real ground issues. You're not pure researchers. So that is how where even in future, in fact, I can see in quite a few of your presentations, you had touched the other angle, the management angle, and how it can actually help conservation. So that's our strength, and a very unique strength. And it's much required, because I see a lot of people in this sector who are drifting. As years progress, they get drifted towards academics. So that's fine. I mean, we need to respect that as well. But there have to be a set of people who work and have an interface with ground conservation. And that is our specialty. And when it comes to collaboration, we should think about collaborating with maybe the IITs, engineers. Maybe they'll open our mind to analysis in a different plane altogether. I mean, it's not that if Dr. Ajit knows t-test, then everybody runs to him. No, we could. And today's era of collaboration, it's so easy to collaborate with a whole variety of people. So just keep an open mind, have a questioning mind, and I think then sky's the limit. This is a sector which badly needs such people, and I think all of you have the potential. So all the best for your future life. Thank you.
So thank you. I think we and now here I will see you guys at 3:30. 9 students who come to the guest house. Thank you.
Thank you.